Every search you do in the Foundation Directory online gives you a set of results. Let's take a look at what you'll need to know about the way results are presented so you can get the most out of those results as quickly and as efficiently as possible. If you need help setting up a search, take a look at the videos on how to search. Let's look at the search results for Ballet School in New York. At the top of each results list is a set of summary boxes that tells you how many grantmakers, grants, recipients, and 990s are associated with your search criteria. This overview is intended to give you a sense of whether or not your criteria is providing results that are on the right track. Note that it is not uncommon to do multiple searches. Each one of those searches will provide valuable research and great prospects. Jump to the Grantmakers section in blue by clicking on the blue box. You'll get a preview of the top five results. Click on the View Grantmakers Only link just below that box to display the full list of grantmakers who have a history of funding that is specific to your search criteria. You can also see this full list if you click on the blue View All box. By default, the most active funders based on the number of grants awarded will be at the top of the list. Amount funded and grant count are the most important columns of the results in terms of finding your best prospects. They represent all giving and are specific to your search, shown in the top gray bar that states Showing Results For. Amount funded tells you the dollar amount of grants given that is specific to your search criteria. Grant count tells you how many grants were awarded. Unlike amount funded and grant count, assets and total giving provide the funder's overall financial data for the last one fiscal year on record. These two columns are not specific to your search criteria. Total giving is the dollar amount of grants given in the last year. Don't be alarmed if the total giving is less than the amount funded. Similarly, if the amount funded is a small percentage of total giving, that may suggest that your work ranks lower in the funder's giving priorities. Assets is the size of the foundation's endowment. For private foundations, it's a quick way to understand how much they might give in a year, because they're required to give at least 5%. Some of the organizations tracked in FDO might lack asset figures, like government agencies or corporate giving programs. But don't worry about that. The amount funded gives you the number you need to know if you want to gauge the relative strength of a prospect. Remember, you can reset the sort order by clicking on any column header, and you can click on any organization name to view that grantmaker's profile. If you want to reduce the number of search results, try using a smaller geographic focus, like nearby counties, instead of your whole state. Or try adding the population served filter if you are serving a specific population. Here, you can also find the filter to exclude grantmakers who aren't accepting applications. However, we don't recommend excluding these funders because they are giving grants for your kind of work, and you deserve to be considered. Learn how to get on their radar with our video on leveraging your networks. Remember, to find most grant opportunities, you'll need to be proactive. If your work aligns with the grantmaker's funding priorities, use your network to make the right connections. Anytime you want to go back and change your search terms to get a new list of results, the top of your results page will display your current search and allow you to add or delete anything you choose. You can also click Find Funding at the very top of the screen to start fresh. Let's go back to our initial search results by clicking on Search Results in the breadcrumbs. The Grants section will show you actual past grants that have been given out by funders in your subject area. On the left, you will see the name of the funder who gave the grant. Next, you will see the organization that received the grant. You will also see the year in which the grant took place and the dollar amount given. Let's click on one of the grant listings. When you do, you will often be able to read a short description of the project that was funded. This is helpful in order to see how closely a funder's giving history aligns with your own work. You can navigate through a list of grants by simply clicking on the next button, or, to return to your search results, click the back button in your browser or the search results link in the breadcrumbs. The recipients section will show you which other organizations are working in your subject area, who has been funding them, and how much funding they have received. Like grantmakers, it is sorted by the most activity. This area is helpful in understanding the funding landscape, seeing how similar organizations have sustained themselves. You could even use it to find potential partners for your organization. In the 990 tax forms area, you can see the most recent tax forms available for funders active in your subject area. Foundation Directory Online has extracted this information and presented it in the grantmaker, grants, and recipient results and profiles. We provide the 990s for reference, but now that we process over 4 million grants per year, the need to dig into the weeds of the 990s is fading fast. Now that you understand what each piece of the results page means, where do you go next? In most cases, you'll want to begin by clicking on grantmaker names within the blue grantmakers section of the results page. This will allow you to read a detailed profile of each funder. To learn how to judge if a funder is a good prospect, watch our video, The Most Important Parts of the Grantmaker Profile. Good luck in your research.